Today I wanted to talk about Virtualenv and what it is and why you should always use it. So it's pretty rare that you only have one Python project on your machine. Chances are you have a bunch of them, from personal projects to things you do for work or school. Chances are also good that each of these projects has slightly different requirements. Your personal site may be running off one set of libraries, while the site for your job uses a slightly different set. They might even have different versions of the same library. This can be a real headache if you're working on both sites on the same machine. This is where Virtualenv becomes super handy. Virtualenv lets you put each of these projects in their own bubble, allowing each one to have its own set of installed apps and libraries. If you've just started coding, you may be tempted to assume that all your projects will always be using the same versions of everything. After all, wouldn't you want the latest and greatest? The reality, though, is that sometimes you have to maintain a legacy site, where you can't upgrade to the latest whatever because of dependencies or lack of funding. You may also need to hold back on an upgrade while other libraries you use catch up. Not every maintainer has the time to keep their code on the bleeding edge. Another reason to use virtualenvs? Peer pressure. Nearly every project assumes that you'll be using virtualenvs. In this vein, a side effect of everyone using virtualenvs is that sometimes code can act weird if you install it as an admin or under root. It's just not a use case that most open source Python devs expect. Finally, using virtualenvs makes it much easier to duplicate your setup. You know exactly what you need to get your code to run, so if you need to set up your environment on a new computer, you can do so in minutes. If all of your code is in one bucket, it's hard to tell what you need and what you don't need. You'll often hear people talk about virtualenv and virtualenvwrapper in the same breath, so you should probably know what virtualenvwrapper is too. Basically, it's a set of tools that make setting up and managing virtualenvs much easier. You want to have both, because not only does it make your life easier, but most projects assume you have both when they put together their install instructions. Quick side note, virtualenv is included in Python 3, but not Python 2. Virtualenvwrapper is not included with either, but is still considered the standard for managing Python environments. Now that we've gone over virtualenv and virtualenvwrapper, let me show you a quick demo of how they work. I'll go over installing virtualenv and virtualenvwrapper in another series of videos so that you don't have to sit through every OS and Python combination to get what you need. Here in my terminal window, I've already installed virtualenv and virtualenvwrapper. First, I want to show you which Python I'm using when I'm not in virtualenv. I also want to show you what I have installed under my native Python. Now I'll create a virtualenv, and as you can see, I'm now using a different Python. There's also way fewer packages when I do pip freeze to see what I have installed. If I pip install something, you can see that I don't need sudo and that it's installing to a directory that is only used by this virtualenv. If I want to exit my virtualenv, all I have to do is type deactivate. To get back in, I type work on and then the name of my virtualenv. And that's it. I'll explain installing virtualenv and virtualenvwrapper in another set of videos since it's slightly different for Mac, Windows, and Linux users. If you have any questions, hit me up in the comments or track me down on Twitter.